on our way to the Rubicon Trail for Jeep Jamboree 2020 Pandemic Edition. I just wanted to show you a couple different things that I did this year to the Jeep. I banged up the Jeep pretty bad when I went to Moon Rocks, which is a local trail here. And I basically tore off the front bumper and did quite a bit of damage to it, mainly to the hard top and the factory doors. And so what I did is I went ahead and put a new bumper. I went with an ARB bumper, mainly because it was easier to get than anything right now, and it was very short notice. I literally just installed it within the last couple days, just in time for this Rubicon Trail. So I do like it. I mean, it looks pretty heavy duty, and I had to make a few minor cuts to get the Xeon 10 worn winch to fit, just very minor on both sides, just to get it to fit snug and clean. Whatever parts I cut, I ended up cleaning, so it looks pretty nice, pretty clean. The other thing that I did is, if you guys saw my video from last year, I was complaining about the Milestar Patagonia tires. I had a few people reach out to me and offered me to try the sticky version of the Milestar Patagonia. So that's what I'm gonna do this year. They're 38 inches, 13 and a half inches wide. I'm hoping they'll work much better. I plan to air them down about 9 to 10 pounds. Last year I was down all the way to 8 and I still couldn't get traction on them. I think the tread was just too hard for these tires. And I'm assuming that Milestar got wind of all the complaints and came out with a sticky version, which they call a black label, and that's what these are. These are the original non-black label, which I still have as a spare. But as you can see, they look almost identical, but I think the tread is just a lot softer on them. As far as that goes, that's pretty much it. The other change is that the Jeep Jamboree changed their radios to Midland radios. GMRS radios, just because you get a lot more service with them as far as distance goes, and CBs at the Rubicon really don't work. Literally, your people come in and out, cutting off everything. So I'm hoping to see how these Midland radios work. And as you can see, again. Well, here's another change I did. I went with a smaller fridge this year. I bought a fridge from Iceco. It's a smaller fridge. I believe it's a 32 liter. And the reason we did that is because the Jeep Jamboree takes good care of us as far as food and drinks go. The only thing that we like to take is, we usually like to go and cook our own meals. And this year we're going to plan to do carne asada at the beach. And so we're taking enough meals just to snack with. And the cooler is just for adult beverages and water and all different drinks. So we're getting ready to head out. We're running a little late, so we're probably gonna go straight to the registration and go there. And the same crew's going with us this year that went with us last year. My son Dilo liked it so much, he decided to fly back up down with us and join us again. And my grandkid, Liam. Say hi, Liam.
Hi.
Liam's usually our backseat coach. And then my wife, Shelly.
Hi.
And so, you guys ready to head off?
Yeah.
Let's do it. a drive-through process where before we could park and register, walk around and shop. Now they converted it into a drive-through process. Then park, then walk around and shop. All right, everybody. Cheers.
Cheers.
COVID-19. 2020 Rubicon Trail pandemic version. Liam, to your fourth Rubicon.
Yes.
Orange.
Buddy.
Thank you. perfect. One more driver.
This is what happens when someone breaks down in front of you.
I offered to stay. That's alright, dude. It's all good. I'd rather you fish the group out. I'm 80% sure that they're going to tell me to turn around.
Although I can't complain.
Well,
the views are amazing from up there.
Yeah, so if that's the case, I'll just rest of the kill spot.
And there's our little mountain climber, Mr. Liam Heaivilin.
Show him what you do.
I need Fortnite.
And there's our friend Cindy.
Hi, Liam.
Thank you.
What's happening, Walter?
Cheers!
Cheers,
man. How's your breakfast, Nim? What'd you have?
Pancake and vegetables and bacon.
Wow, that looks delicious.
This year, the team from Jeep Jamboree hired two different helicopters. And what some of you may not know is that being that it's a sanctioned event by Jeep, breaking down on the trail may require parts to be flown in by helicopter. The driver is then only responsible for the cost of the part. Jeep Jamboree will provide mechanics to get you back on the trail. Liam, did you get a new friend? All right, let's go. Yeah, they have merchandise this time, huh? That fit you.
which is nice. This way, bud. Liam, over here.
This right here is what it's all about, spending time with family and friends.
Beckett, what's your favorite part of the Jeep Jamboree? The food? Yeah?
long walk after Dad's Jeep broke?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, that was fun, you and Mom, huh?
You like hiking for 2 hours?
Yes.
Before you found life?
Yeah.
That's all that you. That's all right, I know. That's all right. That's all right.
And for what only seemed to be a short period at the Rubicon Springs, was actually a day and a half of fun-filled activities. And now it was time to pack our gear and head up the infamous Cadillac Hill and make our way back home.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Nope, we're pushing it down. awesome.
I think I deserve it. Bye, Rubicon. We're at the end of the Rubicon. Did you like it?
Yeah.
You're gonna do it again next year?
Yeah. I got the hiccups.
You got the hiccups?
Yeah.
All the bouncing around?
Yeah.
Well, another good year at the Rubicon 2020. Pandemic edition. We'll see you next year. We'll be right back.
Hey guys, if you made it through the whole video, I really appreciate you watching. I'll be coming up with a lot more content soon, so make sure you hit the like and subscribe buttons. And for those of you wondering, the Milestar Black Label tires were night and day difference compared to my first set of tires, so I would recommend the sticky version of the tires. Well, thanks for watching. Heaivilin's out.